Welcome to Magic TV. I am Tristan Shaun Gregson, here with Louis Scott-Vargas, and hopefully the soon-to-be POY 2010 Brad Nelson. Tell us all about that.
So, there's a time where I was, you know, unbeatable in this race. The day after Grand Prix Toronto, I was feeling really good. And then we go to Worlds, and there's six people that can catch me, and I'm still feeling good, prepared for the event.
I was one of the six, I'll have you.
He was one of the six. And after day one, there was only one left. And then we find out that, you know, Guillaume Matignon rallies off, you know, 11 straight wins.
Guillaume Matignon actually had the backdoor out of winning Worlds and getting 3 points in the team event.
Yeah.
It wasn't just winning Worlds. Yeah. It was winning Worlds and getting 3 points in the team event, which is actually just unreal.
Yeah, he got 28 points to tie me. And I was one win and or one loss away from not having a tie. So it was really random. Like, if my record was one more win, I would have beat him. If I was one more loss, I would have lost. Because I got 3 points. And yeah, so I sweated out top four, where he's playing against PV. I'm sitting with the Frenchies, holding the France flag, like rooting
yeah,
on.
Yeah, because you know. In that match, if PV wins, PV just wins.
Yeah.
So that's the thing. You need for once they were playing in the top four.
Yeah, it was kind of an awkward situation for you.
I needed Guillaume to win and then Guillaume to lose
his next match. Yeah.
I mean, I love Paulo, and in all honesty, if he didn't just win a pro tour, I probably would have rooted for him and be like, "Congratulations, you beat me." But he just won a pro tour. I mean. I'm not going to feel sorry
for him.
It only
goes so far. Teammate, friend, you know, you're like, oh, yeah, you had a good year.
Too much just, is too much.
Come yeah.
Just, yeah.
But, I mean, no one's going to blame me for rooting against people to for you to win player of the
yes,
year.
I know.
So, yeah. I remember watching that match because at the time, me and Brad were in a team event, or a team draft, and Brad's playing. He's playing, and he's like, oh, hold on a second. He's like, middle of the game, middle of an attack step. Walks up, and I just see him, like, staring at the monitor as Guillaume and Paulo are playing, and Brad just, like, shaking his head. And he walks back, and then, you know, Brad rattled off a quick 0-3-0-6, and that draft was just on, like, complete life tilt.
I couldn't think. I heard a clap, and I, you know, instantly turned around.
What's happening? Yeah. Who's winning?
What's going on? I finally, you know, had to, like, just leave the draft on pause and go watch
Yeah,
game
so actually,
three.
He didn't 0-3. He was...
No, I did 0-3, and then...
But we tagged Owen in halfway through.
And so. Then he 0-3'd.
Yeah. But yeah, so, I mean, obviously, you're having a pretty roller coaster of a day there with, like, you know, seeing who makes top eight. You see that both Paulo and Guillaume make top eight. You're like, oh, okay, well, maybe they'll lose. And they both win, and then Guillaume wins again.
And going on...
Again, and it's just...
And also going on with, like... The roller coaster of the bad weekend I had, you know, win, loss, I couldn't
right,
get away from it.
Right,
we're
a top 64 to lock it up.
Yep.
So, it was tough. I mean, obviously, like, you had an insane year, like, you know, no one's going to say that otherwise. But now you have to look forward to the playoff, which we don't actually know the format of.
No. It's cool. Like, it's first time ever. And if you asked me a year and a half ago, told me a year and a half ago that I was in the Player of the Year playoff that's never happened before, I'd be ecstatic.
Yeah, I mean, who wouldn't be?
But yeah, it's played at Pro Tour Grand Prix Paris during Magic Weekend or whatever they're calling it. I think that's what it is, Magic Weekend.
Yeah.
And we don't know what they're going to do yet because they have to figure out when we even play this match because there's so much Magic.
I mean,
going
this
on.
Has never happened before. So the Wizards, besides having the like, there's a playoff at the next Pro Tour. That's the only stated thing we've had.
Mm-hmm.
So we know there's a playoff. We actually don't even know if it's standard, though we're all assuming it is.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, for all I know, like we speculated, it could be a hot dog eating contest. It could be a foot race. It could be, you know, legacy vintage extended. You know,
I would accept all of these things.
Heads up cube draft.
Yeah, I would accept. All of these things and then some, like, I mean, set the stage for us. What do you want?
There's two different things I want. I know I'm not going to get one. I want...
To win?
Well, I want to win.
That's the one he's going to get. But no.
Yeah. Okay. One thing I want is because the year was so long, you know, like, this match isn't, like, for a Pro Tour champion or Grand Prix champion. This is an entire year champion.
Yeah.
So I want it to be more than 2 out of 3. I want it to be more than 3 out of 5. I want 4 of 7, you know? I want a long, drawn-out match where we actually get enough games to see, you know, who gets the edge.
Right. You want to reduce the variance. You want it so, like, obviously in a best 2 out of 3 match, someone can mold a 5 and get mana screwed, and that is decided. And in a 3 out of 5 match that's less likely but still possible, 4 out of 7 will really come down to, like, who's got the better deck.
There's never been a 4 out of 7 before, and there's never been this match before. So why not distinguish it? You know, why not give us an actual marathon?
I think that's actually possible. What I would like... would be maybe multi-format.
Yeah, best of fives.
The thing is, like, this is such a unique situation. They're not going to have this happen very often ever. I think they should milk it for all it's worth. Put it on Sunday. Put it on, like, you know, before the top eight or whatever. Like, have you guys play, like, maybe multiple formats. Like, that would be awesome.
I thought about that, and one of the, you know, standard extended. And then the third format is a draft where I get to pick who's on his left and the two to his right, and he gets to pick who's on his left and his two to, or my two to the right.
Well,
and I get a hate draft, and then we play.
I think that would be kind of weird.
I don't know about that one. I think a Winston draft would be a little more effective.
I think doing the team nationals, standard extended legacy, might actually be
fun. It would be great.
I mean, Guillaume's on the national team. You know, he got to play those.
You'd have to teach me legacy.
Yeah, I mean, I would. Unless Guillaume offered me a good enough incentive for misinformation. Yeah. Thanks. Brad Monterey is perfect in legacy. Chain lightning, you go.
I know what he's playing.
Yeah, but I think that would be awesome. That might be a little much of a production. I think if I were to guess, I would say 3 out of 5 standard would be my guess.
Yes.
That seems like the most obvious.
Seems so vanilla though.
Yeah, I think 2 out of 3 extended, 2 out of 3 standard, 2 out of 3 legacy would actually be awesome. It's you still get your, like, you know, 3 2 out of 3 matches, which
that would be really great.
Which is a lot of matches, and you get, you know, all these different formats. It'd be a lot on you guys to prepare for. Mm-hmm. You'd have to prepare for, but then again, you're already preparing for standard for the Pro Tour anyway.
Yep.
And extended and legacy, I mean, it makes metagaming also less of an issue, because what happens if you guys each pick a standard deck, but it ends up that, like, you know, it's a 90-10 in one of your guys' favor? Like, that's just stupid. Like, player is completely decided by the fact that, you know, he has a 8-card sideboard against your deck or whatever. Whereas if you do it 3 formats, the chances of it happening are much less. Yeah.
And I would want, if it's just standard, I would want our decks to be locked in for what we played in the Pro Tour.
Yeah,
I don't want the single player metagaming.
So there's no individual metagaming. Because, I mean, as much as you want to win Player of the Year, you'd rather win Pro Tour Paris, I would assume.
I mean, I'd rather win Grand Prix Paris.
Yeah. So you have to lock in what you're playing at the Pro Tour, because you play the best deck against the field, not the best deck against the Frenchman.
Yeah.
Though it's in Paris, so maybe actually the anti-French deck might actually be a good call.
I don't have the time to extrapolate on that, but it would be awesome to think of that.
Yes. I mean, and the great thing about this, though, is, like, I really like Guillaume. He drew with me when Guillaume's he could have beat me in San Juan. Like, he helped me get, you know, my points. Like, I helped him by beating him at the next Pro Tour.
And yeah, exactly. I mean, I tested with Guillaume for Pro Tour Berlin, which went well.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Him and Wafo. Because I tested with Olivier, Antoine, him, Wafo, Manuel B., Chapin, Chion. Like, that was our test group. It was the Frenchies plus a couple Americans.
Oh, cool.
And I've interacted with Guillaume a lot. Mm-hmm. You know, like, Guillaume is pretty sweet.
He just loves Magic more than anyone I've ever seen. He just is always excited.
World of Warcraft World Champion 2007?
Something about that, yeah. I heard about that.
Yeah.
Single largest CCG payout ever.
100K. Yeah, 100K. Ship it.
I still think the sickest thing about Worlds was he asked Guillaume Wafotop if he could concede or drop out of the tournament at 2-3.
Yeah.
And Guillaume said no, and then he rattled off infinite wins. He didn't lose another match.
He won the tournament, and he was, like, wanting to drop, so yeah. Obviously, you can't drop to 2-3. I think I don't know if that was a serious question. But, so player year playoff. When we get more information, we'll have more for everyone else. I'm sure we're going to try to figure out something sweet to do leading up to that.
So
maybe post Brad's test journal with, you know, complete misinformation.
I think it's really fun right now for everyone to just, like, you know, what's your dream scenario? What's your dream playoff format? Like, how would you want these guys to play it out? I mean, I like 3 2-out-of-3s. I like 3 3-out-of-5s. I like the 4-of-7 idea, although I don't know if I'd want that in one format. So much sideboard.
Yeah, that's a lot. I think if I had to vote, it would be 3 2-out-of-3s standard extended legacy.
That's actually, that would be better than one match.
That would be sweet, because it's not just one format. It's, like, multiple, and it's, like, it really tests who the player of the year is, not who has the better standard deck this one event. It's 3 different decks. That's enough of a range that you get to play a bunch of different scenarios, situations. It tests your skills as a Magic player.
As far as timing wise goes, I think it'd probably be, I mean, Sunday morning?
I would assume Sunday.
Sunday morning?
Sunday, well, of the top eight. Maybe during the break between the lunch break for, like, after the top eight, first round of top eight.
You have to assume Brad will be in that top eight as well.
Doing it at the same time. They're doing it in between.
They actually have to figure out one thing about it, because if neither one of us or neither of us make
top eight. Oh, if you day two of the GP, because the GP is the same weekend.
And I don't think it would be fair of them to hinder our chances at being Player of the Year 2011 by making
us. Yeah, no, of course not. They're, okay, so that's interesting, too. They have to figure out when. Mm-hmm. They could do it after a GP Swiss round.
If they're still filming.
Yeah.
If they're live filming.
There's a lot of logistics going into this weekend. They've got a lot of interesting stuff to figure out, so hopefully they do a pretty good job of it.
I'd say they just fly us to
Wizards. They could do it on Saturday, like Saturday after the GP, maybe, if it doesn't go too long. It will, though, so,
yeah. Well, yeah, they'd already get their stage set up.
Yeah, but that's something for them to figure out.
Yeah. So. In the meantime, start building decks without Survival of the Fittest in them. Learn what Karn Siller Golem is.
What's Survival of the Fittest? I'm kidding.
A card you no longer have to know about.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's not a card. Don't worry about it.
It's a surprise of no one banned, etc. Anyway, so, yep, Player of the Year playoff. We'll see how it goes. Again, as we get more information, we'll let you guys know kind of where we're at, because I'm sure we'll be doing some promotions, and, too, because, you know, USA.
Yes.
Yeah, all right.
It's been crazy. A lot of people are excited about this. Right when it happened, I realized that every single person in the world that knows about Magic is excited about this, except me, since I didn't win it. Well, I'm happy.
To be fair, I think most people would rather be a playoff. That's just way more exciting.
Of course, yeah, it's awesome.
Instead of the Player of the Year being kind of like an afterthought, which no one really knows about. Mm-hmm. I mean, not that it is that exactly, but like instead of it just being like another thing announced, you know, the winner of the Player of the Year, winner of Worlds, et cetera. Now we've got this thing to look forward to and all the buildup.
It really looked like...
It's actually perfect for Wizards. I think they should be overjoyed.
Oh, yeah, and I think the funny thing about this is it looked like a very boring race at the end.
Yeah.
You know, it looked like I was just going to win it, and like all of a sudden...
Is that what happened, though?
No, there's four matches in the top eight that could determine it.
You know, it wasn't a race, and that was what I was saying for a while. It was like, now you actually had a race. Going into Worlds, it was like Brad's going to walk up on Sunday and pick up a trophy and be like, hey, how's it going? Mm-hmm. But now it's like exciting stuff's going on.
We'll see how it goes, and we'll let everyone know.
Yeah. Stay tuned for the Brad Nelson live blog of life. And
and this is my last day in San Juan. I go back to the cold of Fargo. I'll be back.
San Jose,
sorry.
San Juan.
I'm very tired, jet-lagged.
Yes.
But, I have to say goodbye. I'm going to miss being on the show. Hopefully I come back someday.
Yeah, and we'll get you back on here after you won Player of the Year. But not if you don't. All right, thanks for watching, everyone.